Now back to our developing top story, a warehouse in northeast Albuquerque.
It has been burning all night, and at the height, around 11 o'clock, you could see flames and thick smoke pouring from the roof of one building. Action 7 News reporter A.J. Smith is live at the scene with the latest. A.J.?
Well, Marissa and Christine, we seem to be seeing crews switch out this morning. We've seen several fire trucks heading away from the area, packing up and heading away. But another crew is just getting set behind me right here. As you can see, they're hooking up the hose to the fire hydrant there. So they appear to be getting ready to continue monitoring this fire. Now, they say they've managed to contain the flames to that one building. But as I mentioned, they're still monitoring. And up until a few minutes ago, they were dousing hot spots to make sure the fire doesn't reignite in the adjoining buildings. Now they say that could cause some really dangerous problems. The fire started inside Cottonwood Storage. It's a cardboard box storage business that supplies boxes to vendors all over Albuquerque. All that cardboard provided incredible fuel for the flames. They grew so intense the building's roof collapsed. And firefighters worried that the flames might spread to two other warehouses with even more potentially hazardous materials inside. The Big Bear Oil Company houses drums of petroleum that could create giant explosions if ignited. And the Lazy Boy warehouse is filled with upholstered furniture containing foams made up of chemicals that become very hazardous as they start to melt.
It's a high hazard fire because of all the foams. So far, the firewalls on the adjoining structure have been doing their job pretty well. It stopped forward progress to the adjoining unit. And at this time, we're trying to protect that exposure.
And as I mentioned, firefighters right now attaching the hose to the fire hydrant. Again, we've seen several trucks leave. We've only seen one come in, so it does appear that they are starting to tone down the number of firefighters that are here on scene. Reporting live in northeast Albuquerque, A.J. Smith, KYT Action 7 News, live this morning.
More details now. The fire happened right across the street from a firefighters' union hall where many firefighters were the first ones to call in the blaze. It's in the same spot where another giant warehouse blaze gutted buildings 7 years ago. We'll have more on that previous fire in our next half hour. The cause is still under investigation, and arson units remain on the scene as standard procedure.
Well, the raging plumes of smoke drew a large crowd of onlookers. Action 7 News reporter Lee Chekstad continues our team coverage with their perspective.
Outside their home for more than an hour watching the flames and smoke.
Sometimes it slows down and then it goes like the flames go up higher now. So
the parking lot next to their home filled up with others looking to do the same.
That's pretty scary. Looks like somebody's business is up in smoke.
Some sat just watching, some cars drove by and kept going. Others, like Anthony Correa, wanted to get as close to this fire as possible.
Make sure everyone's okay, I guess.
In Albuquerque, Lee Chekstad, KOAT, Action 7 News.
And depend on Action 7 News for continuing coverage of this developing story. We're going to bring you the latest in all of our newscasts today and anytime on our website, KOAT.com.